possibility of you starting to bloat or retain some water in the first week of transforming into the power food lifestyle, there is that possibility. And here's the reason why. There are three electrolytes in your body, okay? Sodium, magnesium, and potassium. When we suddenly go from a very conventional food, the SAD diet, the standard American diet is what they call it, just basically eating processed refined foods, maybe dining out, eating fast food, skipping meals, when we go from that into a power foods lifestyle pretty quickly, the sodium levels can go drop pretty rapidly. Now, average intake for an everyday human is gonna be 2,200 milligrams per day. That's what our body needs. So a lot of people think sodium is bad. No, sodium is not bad. Too much sodium is bad. Too much sodium is not helpful to our bodies, except for in the case of high blood pressure where you really do need to watch that sodium content. For everybody else, I want you to be very mindful that if you convert to 70% plus of power foods lifestyle, your sodium content is gonna drop. And so if you are not getting enough sodium, if you are not salting your foods, you probably will bloat because there's an imbalance of those electrolytes. So a few things you need to make sure happen. Number one, salt your foods. You should be using either sea salt or pink Himalayan salt. You need to salt your foods, whether it's a scramble, a stir fry, a salad, a soup. You don't need to salt a shake, but if you're salting all of your other foods, you should be good to go there. Now, here's the other thing. You need to be taking your 400 to 500 milligrams of magnesium in the evening. Now, this is the second electrolyte. Now, the third electrolyte, you usually only need to bring in if you reduce the number of carbs pretty dramatically, and that would be the potassium. If you are eating fewer than 2 PVC meals per day, I would love to see you bring in 50 to 100 milligrams of potassium per day. Please, of course, always check with your healthcare provider, particularly if you are on any medications. Just double check. It's worth that phone call or going in just to make sure. But usually these principles will help us to balance out those electrolytes. And so we're feeling okay. We're avoiding the bloat. We're not having the water retention underneath the skin, that subcutaneous layer. It's a yucky feeling. Now females who are having a menstrual cycle, of course, will experience that during that time of the month. That's very common. And no, you can't really mitigate that or take away from it. The only thing you really can be doing, make sure you're drinking plenty of water, make sure that you are still salting your foods, and just try to get through it. There's really no way around it or to mitigate it, which is unfortunate. But the final question I'll answer is, what if you feel like you're still not getting enough electrolytes? How can you get that? Because you don't want to do the sugary Gatorades or Propels, and you don't necessarily want the artificial sweeteners of the Powerade Zeros or the G2s or whatever those are, any of these, you know, they've got the sucralose in them. And again, it's guilty until proven innocent, right? We really want to reduce our amount of artificial sweeteners. And so how do you get those electrolytes? Well, a few things here. Some people tell me, Christy, I'm just not gonna salt my foods. And I say, that's fine. You ready to take a salt tablet? And they're like, oh no. you can just do a pinch of salt in water. I personally like to drink pickle juice, especially if you have low blood pressure. I have low blood pressure. And so if I start to feel like that's dropping too much, I'll drink pickle juice. I actually make my own pickles. I just learned how this summer. I'm loving it. But that can be a great way to make sure you are getting enough sodium. The second thing is, I will have a link for a new product. I just met this company a few months ago. They make their electrolyte supplement using minerals from the Great Salt Lake here where I live. And a really wonderful company. So I'll make that link available to you if you're interested in that. That just goes in your water. Maybe you're an athlete, a long endurance athlete or something like that. So that can be a great way, especially kids who are playing outside in the hot sun. They're athletes, they're playing football, they're out there playing baseball or soccer. This can be a good thing to put in their water as well. So this should help you eliminate the bloat, balance out those electrolytes, and remember there's three and they work together. So where there's a reduction in one, there's gonna be a compensation in the other. And so usually following those principles will help you to figure all of that out.